let's get fucking crazy!
That's right, fly guys and fly girls. Today we are going to tie this bream pattern of mine. This fly belongs to a family of flies called AFMs, which basically are sparsely tied flash flies. And it consists of two bucktail colors, one gray in the back and one tan in the front, which makes the fly go from a darker color into a slightly lighter one. And it has this nice gray and brown blend of flash with some lemon, some green in there as well. It's a nice searching pattern. I tied it originally as a bream pattern, but it's probably a little bit too small to be an actual bream, even though of course there exists smaller bream as well. But as I said, it's a nice searching pattern. It's worked quite well for me over the last two seasons. And also I've been tying this for orders for a lot of other guys who also reported having quite good fishing with it. For me, it's been a fly that's been best for autumn fishing. Early autumn and also actually some midsummer fishing, because we have a lot of eide in my waters. And this actually could also mimic an eide, with the dark brown and gray colors. The trick with maintaining a good movement in a fly like this is tying it sparsely. And you're gonna see in a little while when you start tying that I don't use much flash, I don't use much bucktail, and I don't use very much Nayat. But when it combines, it gives an overall impression and a really good profile to this fly. You can do the head of this fly in two different versions, as you're gonna see when we tie it lately. You can either add UV resin, like bog bond, to the head, or you can use the kind of butt ends to the Nayat to create a sheep fleece like head, and this is what we are going to do today. So, without further ado, let's start tying. Let's just quickly go through the materials needed to tie this fly. I'm also going to leave a full material listing in the description below. Gonna start by using the Partridge Attitude Streamer hook in size 4.0, but the Universal Predator hook will also work just fine. The articulated Shank in 35mm size will be used in front of that. You're gonna use bucktail in colors gray and tan, and you're also gonna use Nayat in two colors, in this case brown and black. You're gonna use saddle hackle, gray and olive grizzly, and you're also gonna need flash first. Bauer pike flash in the colors copper, lemon and chartreuse, and then finally Sybai tinsel flash in the colors brown and grey. Preparing all your material before starting to tie a fly will really speed up your tying. And if you are planning to tie more than one fly of the same pattern, it will also ensure you that you will use the same amount of materials for each fly, which will increase the chances of the flies being close to identical. This prep rack that I'm using to set up all my materials was made for me by a good friend of mine, Andreas Andersson. Great fly tyer and one of the nicest people you'll meet. You simply cut off all the material you're gonna use and place them in the slots of the rack in the order you plan to use them. Now everything is prepped. It's time to start tying. So, first things first. You're probably wondering, why the heck am I doing a voiceover on myself? Well, there's actually three reasons for this. One being the fact that I don't, yet, have an external microphone connected to my camera, which makes the sound quality less than good and puts me in a screaming mode more or less all the time. The second reason is the fact that I managed to catch the commentary for the entire first half of the Arsenal vs Crystal Palace football game in the background. And since I'm a lazy bastard, I didn't want to reshoot the entire set because of this. The final reason is the fact that I can now correct all the weird things I said when recording the fly tying and add more sensible commentary.
Also, you will now not hear all the that I noticed I started all my sentences with. So, let's start our tying with putting the hook that we're gonna use in the vise. It's a matter of personal taste what hook you want to use. Any of the partridge hooks, like the Universal Predator, the Universal Predator X, or the one that I'm using here, the Attitude Streamer, work just fine. Make sure it's a 4-0 hook though, since that will make a perfect match to the articulated shank that we're gonna use later. Start with adding a base of super glue to the shank of the hook to firmly secure the thread as we tie it in. I'll tie the thread in almost halfway back on the shank. This is the back section of the fly, where you will basically tie one section of combined material. You can choose where you want to have it in this section to achieve different movement into fly. You can tie it here in the middle, back at the hook bend, or even close to the hook line. The reasons why I choose to tie it here in the middle of the hook is that I've found it makes the fly more balanced, and you will also have the hook point riding slightly hidden in the material, which will make it act as something of a built-in weed guard. But I would say the main reason for tying it here would be that you will get enough space between the back section and the front section of the fly, which will create enough air between the two parts, which in turn will result in better movement and better translucency in the fly. The first thing we're going to tie in is a color of bucktail. This is gray bucktail here that I'm using. The build-up of the fly is done by using two sparsely tied bucktail colors, one on the hook and one later on the articulated shank. By tying in this color with the tip pointing backwards, so no reverse tying, it will rise up to a lesser angle than for the front part, which you will see later, we will tie in traditionally and then fold back. This will again help the fly with the movement, since the material in the front section will have a slight pocket of free space over the materials in the back, ensuring we minimize tangling of the material. Now, just chop off these roots ends to the bucktail. You don't have to be super neat when doing this. Then just secure the wraps with some super glue. Now it gets exciting, because the next thing I'm gonna use is Nayat. For those of you not familiar with Nayat, it's a unique natural material, perfectly suited for pike flies. It combines length with a stiffness and structure to the hair that you can't find in, for example, Icelandic sheep or goat. And it's this that makes it so interesting, because that will prevent it from tangling around the hook or with other material that a lot of other long hair material will do. It will add structure, color, and fantastic movement to your flies. So, cut off a small piece of Nayat, but don't comb out the underwool, since it will help you supporting the flash later on. Tie it in a few millimeters in front of the bucktail by encapsulating the bucktail like this. Then do a couple of open turns with the thread before tightening. Then comb everything through to blend the bucktail and Nayat together. Like that. Looks pretty neat, doesn't it? Just cut off the waist now and secure it with a few extra turns of the thread. And then secure it all with more super glue. Next thing that I'm tying in is the saddle hackle feathers. We'll start with the olive grizzly ones. Start by tying one in at the 2 o'clock position, which means roughly just to the side of the absolute top of the fly. I'm using the saddle hackle as a guide here to how long the fly eventually will end up. And I've found that if I keep the length as long as the back of my regal vise, it's perfect to me, and the fly will end up some 28-29 centimeters long. This is probably the longest I tie my flies without adding stinger rigs to them. The next hackle feather will be to the opposite side of the top, at the 10 o'clock position. Make sure that you taper the feathers so they are slightly different in length to each other, This will enhance movement in the fly later. The remaining two grizzly olive feathers will be tied in at each side of the fly. Placing the feathers like this on the top half of the fly will give an illusion of the fly being darker on the top. Now, cut off the waist end of these feathers. The grey feathers will be tied in on the sides and on the underside of the fly. Tie the first two in just above the olive ones that you tied in on the sides. And the remaining two will be tied in on the underside. And if you're still looking at your watch, it would be like at 5 and 7 o'clock. Now, can we stop this clock thing please and just tie? A final touch of super glue to secure the feathers, and now to the flash. The flash blend on this fly is essential for the final look of it, and also keeping it sparse is the key to maintain good movement in the fly. Use about 6 to 8 strands of the Bauer pike flash in the color lemon. Then use another about 8 to 10 strands of the Bauer pike flash, this time in the color copper. The Sybai tinsel flash is much thinner, so you can use up to 15 strands of that. And then finally add 6 to 8 strands of the mirage flash on top of that. Blend everything together using a comb and your finger to produce a nice gold and brown mix. The trick here is not to use too much flash in either of the sections. If, after you've tied in the flash, feel like, this fly needs a little bit more flash, then it's actually perfect. Because you have to remember that it is the combined volume of both the front and the back part of the fly that make it a hold. Make sure you have tapered the ends so that all strands of flash feels like it's different in length. Use a 60-40 spread of the flash with 60% of it pointing backwards. And spread the flash around the shank, and while holding the flash and the material at the back down, just add a couple of open turns, and when you're sure that the flash is spread around nicely, add a couple of more hard turns of the thread to secure it. Then, with your fingers, fold all the flash back, and again, make sure that it's evenly spread. Hold everything down while tying the flash down, and then secure it with several hard turns. And do I really need to tell you to add a little super glue here again? Then tie the thread off at this point. Call me old fashioned, but I do like to secure the thread with a couple of whip finishes before cutting it off. You can then comb everything through again to make sure you blend all the materials together. Now the back section of the fly is finished. As you can see when I'm holding it like this, the bucktail collar makes a nice base with a nice angle to the entire back section. Sparse with material to get a lightweight and highly pulsating tail section. Now, if I wouldn't have used the Nayat between the bucktail and the feathers and flash, those materials would have fallen through the bucktail color easily. So the Nayat not only gives us base color and movement, it also gives a protective layer that holds all the material up in a way that would have been impossible with only a bucktail color this sparse. This makes it easier to use really sparse bucktail colors on a hook shank, where the diameter is in comparison so much smaller than on a tube. This is one of the problems I see a lot of people have when trying to go from the popular tube flies to articulated hook flies. You can also use craft fur and any other type of hair as well to create the same type of protection layer if you can't get hold of Nayat. Now to something completely different.
That was so disturbing.
Okay, now to tying the front section of the fly. We'll insert the back section that we've just tied into one of these 35mm articulated shank. This shank will do a couple of things for this fly. It will of course add enhanced movement to the fly, like this, and that, and this. It will also move the hook back for you, which will increase the chance of hooking the fish more than you think. Insert the shank into your vise like this. I recommend you fasten the back section of the fly with a clip to get it out of your way while tying the front section. To close the open ends of the shank, you will add super glue to both parts and then slide the thread in between and tie them together firmly with many thread wraps. Also, make sure that the ends are parallel, so that you don't get an unbalanced section to your fly. As long as you don't tie any material over this later, you can always cut it open and change the back section if the hook has become damaged or dull. I've seen people using feather rings between the hook and shank too, to make it easier to change the back hook. Personally, I think that it changes the movement of the fly in a way that I don't like, so I never use that setup. Next bucktail color is the tan one. Remember to keep it sparse. Now this color you are going to tie reversed. You're going to tie it with the tips to the front of the fly and then fold back the bucktail in a more traditional way, like you've seen Nayat Bauer do on his fantastic flies. So this is pretty straightforward. You tie the bucktail down just in front of the closed section of the shank. Spread it around the shank and add a couple of loose wraps of thread before you tighten it to make the hair spin and rise up like this. Use several hard turns to further tighten it here. Cut off the waist of the bucktail and this time be more thorough and neat with how you cut it down to prevent any problem when folding it back later. Use any type of hollow cap with the right diameter to push the hairs back. Use your fingers as a complement to make sure the hair have spread around and are not twisted around the shank. The secret to getting a bucktail color with the angle you want it to have is to tie a cone of thread with a longer tapering than you might think you'll need. Because if you try and stack thread wraps here, just in front of the bucktail color, it won't work. Everything will start to slide forward, it will collapse and you'll have loose thread wraps and everything. Work the tapering from the front to the back, slowly building it up to a point where you're happy with the way it sits and the angle it has. Again, like we did on the back section, we are going to add Nayat over the bucktail. Spread the Nayat in your hands like this before encapsulating the bucktail with it. And again, do a couple of loose wraps and then tighten it all when you're sure that it's evenly spread around, covering the bucktail color everywhere. Now, maybe I should add something around this.
Which is thus, which I can't even speak.
Yeah, and you wonder why I did a voiceover. Comb everything through to blend the Nayat and bucktail together and cut off the waist of the Nayat. Now, you created another good base to add the next flash bundle on. For the back section, we're gonna change the flash blend slightly. You're gonna use the same amount of the Bauer Pike flash in the color copper. You're also going to use the color lemon, but this time only about 4 to 5 strands. You will then add the Bauer Pike flash in the color green, also about 4 to 5 strands. The Sybai tinsel flash in the color brown, will be used the same amount as we did in the back section. And then you will add Sybai tinsel flesh in the color gray, also the same amount, roughly around 15 strands. A general tip here before tying in the flesh. Always make sure that you move forward with the thread a few millimeters from the previous material that you tied in before tying in the next one. Because creating those kind of spaces, those small air pockets between materials, will increase the movement of all materials in the fly. You'll probably never hear me say things like this is the correct way to do it or you have to tie it like this. Because if there is one thing that I've learned over the years tying flies, is that there are so many ways you can do things without it being right or wrong. Be thorough with securing the material right and considering the attributes of each material, then you can achieve so many different types of effects depending on where you tie it, how you tie it, what you combine it with, etc. So there's no wrong or right, I just show my way of doing things, but I'm sure there are many other ways you can do it that are probably are better too. Okay, enough rambling about that. You've seen me tie in the flash now, pretty much the same way that we did for the back section. If you want to, you can also cut this bundle of flesh down 2 to 3 centimeters before tapering the ends and tying it in. Still using 60-40 spread to the flesh. Once you're happy with how it's spread around the shank, you fold it back and secure it once again with several turns of thread. Comb through it again to blend the flash, Nayat and bucktail together and to make sure you've spread the flash around evenly around the fly. Fasten your clip to get all the materials out of your way before preparing the head. The head of the fly, which I forgot to prep, is going to be made from only Nayat. There are however two different ways you can do the head. You can either clip off the root ends to the Nayat and then just add an uberizine like bug bun as a head, which will create a slightly heavier head that will give you more of a jigging effect. Or you can fold and tie back the root ends, creating a head similar to a sheep fleece head, and that's exactly what I'm going to show you here. To create a nice mottled effect to the head, I'm using both black and tan Nayat, which I'm going to mix in a certain way. First, cut off a small piece of black Nayat, and then the same amount of tan Nayat. Place the tan Nayat over the black with the tips aligned. As you can see, the black is longer than the tan here. So basically just cut off the root ends of the black so all Nayat is equal in length. With the tan over the black, divide it in two separate parts, placing one of them in front of you on your tying desk. The other one you will tie in on the top and sides of the shank. Place the Nayat bundle with the black facing down and the root ends sticking out about 2 centimeters. Hold the Nayat firmly and add a couple of looser wraps. Make sure that you have the Nayat only on the top and sides of the shank before securing it with harder turns of thread. Turn the fly over and do the same thing with the other bundle of Nayat, remembering to keep the black on the underside. Be careful not to spin the baldus around and secure both with hard wraps of thread while holding everything with your other hand. I'm now going to split the head in two parts. The easiest way to do this is to stroke the root ends back and then try and grab about 50% of the head, the part closest to the hook, with your other hand. In this case it's easier since it's all the black Nayat. And if you have some black hairs that go back or some tan that stays at this point, it doesn't really matter that much. Now keep the thread a little tight and do 4 hard turns with it between the two head sections. Keep tension of the thread all the time and fold the rest of the Nayat back before you slip the thread in front of that. Tie several hard turns of thread in front of the entire head. Press everything back and up. Hold the rough head back and add super glue to the thread wraps and slightly into the hairs as well. Then carefully press the head back around the entire fly. But be careful, do not glue your fingers to the fly. Break out your comb again and comb everything back to untangle it and to create a nice base to glue the eyes on. The eyes I'm using here are big predator size 15mm living eyes from Flyman Company. I'm a firm believer of eyes as a trigger point for pike flies and probably wouldn't fish a fly without eyes on it. Use super glue in gel form for the best results when attaching them to the fly. Add glue to the eye before pressing it on the head, not the other way around. I like to place it a millimeter or so back from the hook eye for a nicer look of the head. Then add the second eye to the other side and press both eyes together firmly while stroking all the material in the head back. Pressing them like this will create a slightly more flat head, which will make the fly cut nicely to the sides when retrieved. Cut off the thread now. If you feel you need to, you can comb through the fly once again. Take the fly off the vise and use a long blade scissors, begin to cut the head to the shape you want. I'm actually rather lousy at this and my heads never end up like the way I'm wanting to. The trick is to be patient and cut off small pieces at a time, aiming for a triangular shape to the head. Once it begins to look like you want, switch to a smaller scissor and work the details a bit. You can also put the fly back with the hook eye in the tying vise to support the cutting of the head. There's actually not much left to do with this fly now. It's now all done and ready to get viciously attacked by a freshwater crocodile. Speaking of which, the bites on these flies are actually quite sneaky.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Are you okay? I didn't see you there. Here, let me help you up. Are you sure you're okay? Is that your wallet on the ground there? Few bream flies then. Okay. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for watching. Hope you've enjoyed yourself. Hope you've had a good time. Hope you've learned something. Till next time, do like the pike's tooth and stay sharp. See ya. Yes, that's all done.